Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Hope you all are good. Today, I will teach you about reproduction. This topic is taken from your book, Unit 2, Reproduction in Living Things. Now, what is reproduction? As you all know, living things create new living things of their own kind. This is called reproduction. Reproduction means to reproduce. It is a process by which an organism produces an offspring of their own kind. Reproduction occurs in plants as well as in animals. Today we will discuss about reproduction in animals. We have two types of animals according to their mode of reproduction. The animals which lay eggs and the other animals which give birth to babies. So birds, frogs, lizards, fish and insects lay eggs. The young are made inside the eggs. After some time, they hatch out from the eggshells. They grow up and exactly look like their parents. Other are the animals which give birth to babies. Dogs, cats, crows and sheep produce live babies and feed them on milk which is produced in the mother's body. They look after them until they are strong enough to look after themselves. These are the animals. The upper three are the animals which lay eggs, and the last two are the animals which give birth to their live babies. Now, we will discuss some reproductions in different types of animals. So, number one is reproduction in butterflies. You all are familiar with butterflies. Now, how this process occurs in butterflies? Female butterfly lays 100 of eggs. These are the eggs. From these eggs, the larva comes out, or we can say caterpillar. They fed on the leaves. Caterpillar then moved to dry place and form shell called cocoon. Inside it, the insect becomes a pupa. The pupal stage is also called a resting stage. The cocoon breaks and the pupa transformed into a complete butterfly. This is how the reproduction is done in butterfly. Egg, larva, or we can say that caterpillar larva, the pupal stage, and finally the adult butterfly. Second is reproduction in frogs. Female frog lays eggs in a pond. These eggs stick to each other in a jelly form called spawn. In this way, the eggs are stick together. After 10 days, this jelly around egg melts and a tiny frog tadpole come out. It has a tail and a head and its body is long. Gill starts growing after 4 weeks. This tadpole changes into froglet. And after 6 to 9 weeks, legs begins to appear. And finally, after 3 months, the tadpole or the froglet changes into complete frog. In this way, the reproduction is done in frog. First eggs, then tadpole, then froglet, and finally the adult frog. Reproduction in birds. We all have seen a beautiful birds. Birds build their nest in which female lays 2 to 4 eggs. Each egg has a hard outer shell. Female sits on the eggs to keep them warm. And after 2 to 4 weeks, the eggs hatch and baby emerges. You can see in this picture. The eggshell breaks and the baby comes out. Both parents feed and look after the baby till they are strong enough to fly and feed themselves. In some birds, such as the chicken, the chicks can run about and find food soon after hatching, but they stay close to their mother for some time. In this way, the reproduction is done in birds. Finally, the reproduction in mammals. In humans and other mammals, the female gives birth to babies. As soon as the baby is born, it begins to feed on its mother's milk. Both parents look after the baby until they completely mature. When the young animals are strong enough to find their food, they leave their parents. Except in humans, like us, who do not leave their parents until they are adults. So in this way, the reproduction occurs in mammals. Okay students, this is all about the reproduction in animals. Thank you.